हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ अवर लेसन, रीच फॉर द टॉप. सो इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव लर्न और वी रेड अबाउट द संतोष यादव. इन सेकेंड पार्ट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द मारिया शरापोवा. सो शी इज द बेसिकली रशियन गर्ल. She is from Russia, but this is the story of her, how she became the leading tennis player. So let's see. A Russian girl, Maria Sharapova, reached the summit of the women's tennis when she was barely 18 years old. As you read about her, see if you can draw a comparison between her and Santosh Yadav. So see, she was only 18 years old, means very young, and she was the best on the top of the tennis player. So let's see it. There is something disarming, means likable, about Maria Sharapova, something at odds with her ready smile and glamorous attire. And that something in her lifted her on Monday, 22nd August 2005, to the world number one position in women's tennis. She got the first rank on 22nd August 2005. First position in the women's tennis. All this happened in the almost no time. So this was happening very rapidly. No time means very fastly. She was grieving up very rapidly, very fastly. Poised beyond her years, the Siberian born teenager took just 4 years as a professional to reach the pinnacle. So it means only a very, she was very calm, very elegant, that it took her only 4 years to become pinnacle, means the most famous or successful point. She got, that is the first rank, she got the first rank within the 4 years. So it shows that how determined she was to her aim, to her goal. However, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world began 9 years before with a level of sacrifice few children would be prepared to endure. So she was grieving up very rapidly, very fastly. And like that, when the children who is on that age were suffering, enduring means suffering patiently, on that time she was getting all this. Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in the United States. United States means USA. So it means she was not the 10 years old also, but on that age, it means ninth year. At the age of the ninth, she was ready to go USA. The trip to Florida is situated in USA, with her father, Yuri launched her on the path to success and stardom. So see, after a child, there is a very big responsibility of a parent to support them. So like this, her parents, her father was also very determined, very objective, very career oriented, and that is why he support him and he was with him. But it was also required a heart-wrenching, means extremely sad, very sad moment. 2 years separation from her mother Yelena, but she was with his father only. The latter was compelled to stay back in the Siberia because of visa restrictions. But because of the some visa restrictions, her mother will not able to go to the USA. So it was a very extremely sad moment for them, and that is why there was only her father with her. The 9-year-old girl had already learned an important lesson in life, that tennis excellence would only come at a price. So only on when she is 9-year-old and she got the lots of lessons, lots of experience, and because of, with the help of that experiences, she understood what is the price of her excellence. I used to be so lonely, Maria Sharapova recalls. I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going, so he couldn't see me either. So it means, she recalls, she just reminds that she was very sad. She was very missing her mother very terribly, but her father was very supporting. He was not doing anything. He was only supporting her. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. The other tennis pupils means students, would come in at 11 p.m. and wake me up and order me to tidy up the room and clean it. So it is like a ragging. When she was supposed to sleep at 8 p.m. but her roommates came on 11 p.m. and just doing the ragging. They were ordering her that just clean the room. Wake up and clean the room. Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. But in this situation, lots of students got depressed, got very sad. But this moment or this, because of this tough time, she is now very determined. She has lots of mental strength. And she said, in that moment, I should become sad, but no, that moment was making me very strong. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting, means leaving, because I knew what I wanted. So she learned, she knows that how to take care of herself, how to take care of her dreams. So she decided, whatever comes on my way, but I will do what I want to do. She will never get depressed by that. When you come from nothing and you have nothing, then it makes you very hungry and determined. Means she don't have anything, and she know she don't have anything to lose also. And that is why it makes her very determined, very firm towards her goal. I would have put up with much more humiliation. Humiliation means insults. And insults than that to steadfastly pursue my dreams. And because of that, she was following her dream. Because of that humiliations, insults, she was actually rapidly going towards her dream. That toughness runs through Maria even today. It was the key to her bagging the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004 and to her meteoric, means very rapid, rise to the world number one spot the following year. So because of that toughness, she was winning. While her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis has touched the heart of the tennis fans. So who are the tennis fans, who are the actual player of the tennis? The journey of this Maria's touch them. How she was a very young and she was nothing, but now what she have, it was a great inspiration to the tennis fans. For the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment, no any emotional. The straight looks and answers she gives when asked about her ambition makes it amply, means plentifully, clear that she considers the sacrifice worth it. So whenever she is asked that lots of tough nights, lots of hard work you did, but she just said, no, all that tough things, all that hard words worth it, because of that I am today here. I am very, very competitive. She loves to take a competition. I work hard at what I do. It's my job. This is her mantra for success. So she says she is very competitive. She loves to take the competition. She works hard for that, and that's her job. Nothing else. It is very simple. It's her success mantra. Tough though, Maria Sharapova speaks with a pronounced American accent. She proudly parades, displays her Russian nationality. So because of age of 9, she was in America. So that from, it was a very long time. So there was in her pronouncing, in speaking, there was an American accent. But she is proudly saying she is Russian. So there is no any shyness. I am Russian. Sorry, clearing all doubts, she says, I am Russian. It's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian. I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me. So she say, yes, it is, there is no any doubt, this America made me. I take a lots of struggle and achievement also in this, in America. But in, I am a Russian, I have the Russian citizenship. In my blood there is a Russia, totally Russian. So if they will offer me, or if they will give me a chance, I would love to take a part in Olympics for the playing for the Russia. Like any number of teenage sensations, Maria Sharapova lists fashion, singing and dancing as her hobbies. She loves reading the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. Her fondness for sophisticated evening goes appear at odds with her love of pancakes with chocolate spread and fizzy orange drink. So it is like she loves to eat the pancakes, to attend the parties, or drinking the fizzy, it is one drink. Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. Her talent, unwavering desire to succeed, and readiness to sacrifice have lifted her to the top of the world. So it means she was very firm what she wants to do. She was very desirable what she wants to do. So that is why she was very on the top of the world. Few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. Monetary gains means money. Of course, money is a motivation. Tennis is a business and a sport. But the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That's the dream that kept me going. So she says, yes, I got lots of money because of tennis, because this is the very beneficial for me that I am playing, and while I am playing I am getting money. So it is the play, it is the game also, and it is one business also. But important thing for her that she is top of the world, she is the number one player, and that thought is making or keeping her going, that she don't stop, she should not stop. So this is the also second inspiration story of Maria Sharapova. I hope you understand this. In both of the story we have learned that we should be very formed, we should be very determined, we should have one admire person, inspiration, and to them we should follow, we should have one goal, what I want to become in my life, and step by step we should follow that, we should have that determination so that we will get that in our life. I hope you understand this second inspirational story also. Read this in your home. We will meet in next video. Thank you.